Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about, did Postgres lose my data, or was it an ICU collation change? This is a blog post by Jeremy from the AWS team. And what Jeremy talks about here is a hypothetical situation where he is a linguistics researcher that works with the Balti language of northern Pakistan. The reason that Jeremy picked this language is because it had some recent collation changes, which we'll talk more about in a moment. In order to do the linguistics research work here, Jeremy sets up a new EC2 instance with Ubuntu and installs Postgres 15. An important aspect is that Jeremy chooses the ICU collation provider. Jeremy inserts some test data into the database and then is able to run some queries. He says, what if I want to scale this out? And so adds a hot standby to the setup that is replicating from the primary. He also uses Ubuntu LTS for the hot standby, and he uses the same Postgres version. Now, queries are faster, but then he discovers a problem. He's horrified to discover that his hot standby here seems to have lost a huge amount of data. He's running a count, and then suddenly on the hot standby, it's not returning any data. On the primary, everything looks fine. We stop using the hot standby server because clearly there is some kind of problem. Luckily, the primary is still safe. This is something that you can replicate yourself if you follow Jeremy's instructions here. The main thing to understand is that the reason this happened, the reason this data seemingly was lost, is because of a difference in the Ubuntu release that Jeremy used here. Essentially, not being super careful, he used one LTS version at one time, and then he used another LTS version the other time. The primary is Ubuntu 20.04. The secondary is Ubuntu 22.04. Postgres wants you to use both the same Postgres version as well as the same OS. Oftentimes, end users don't necessarily look at the Postgres logs, but if you were to look at the Postgres log, you would have actually seen a very helpful message that says, database research text has a collation version mismatch. Database was created using collation version 1.5.3.14, but the operating system provides 1.5.3.1.1.2. So there's a newer version on the operating system side. Rebuild all objects in a database that use the default collation and run all the database refresh collation version or build Postgres with the right library version. Collations are a complex topic. There has been a lot of writing about this over the years. The way that Jeremy summarizes this here is collation is essentially putting words in the right order, sorting strings so that they follow the rules of local languages, of local practices, so that the database returns the sort data in the way that you expected. Postgres itself does not actually handle collation versioning. Instead, Postgres outsources this. Postgres either uses the glibc library or the ICU library for handling collations in sort order. These libraries are part of the operating system. And this is where the problem comes in. When you upgrade those external libraries, then the ordering rules change. And really the big issue you have is that there is this inconsistency between the new ordering in the library logic and what's on disk. This is rare in practice, luckily, but when it happens, it can cause wrong query results. It can cause duplicate data violating unique constraints. Really sucks. You expect there to be one row and suddenly there's three rows and you're like, which one is the right row? I've seen this myself on the database and it's not good. This is a problem that has existed for Postgres for many years. In a sense, now we should be in a better place because this is using ICU, this is using explicit collation versioning, but you don't really escape the problem that you have to think about collation. And Jeremy says, ultimately, this is a fact of life. And so what he's actually done is he created the GitHub repo where he looks at both the glibc as well as the ICU sort order changes over time. He's done a very thorough analysis on the different glibc versions, for example, bundled in Ubuntu, and how they've changed their sort order over time, as well as ICU versions. And if you're interested in this topic, or if you're trying to understand, could this be hitting us when we upgraded our OS, then this is a good resource. If you're interested more in terms of how does this work, why are collations a problem, Peter Eisentraut wrote a great article on how collations work a couple of weeks ago. If you're interested in the topic of collations, this is a great reference post. And then Jonathan Katz from the AWS team also talked a little bit about collation changes on AWS Aurora and RDS. What's important to note is that you don't necessarily escape this problem when you're on AWS, but one thing that they've introduced recently is that they're actually pinning the glibc collation version. They've essentially said the collation part of glibc will freeze it to be 2.2.6.5.9, which is one very particular glibc version, and they won't upgrade that, which means that when you're using Amazon RDS and Aurora and you're using glibc collation in your database, you can be reasonably sure that this won't break I think this is an interesting aspect of how to solve it, but it doesn't solve it if you're using the ICU collations. It is good to have some awareness of this when you're using the more advanced ICU features in Postgres. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.